What's going on, guys? It's Kyle getting ready to compete in the Road Warrior Series, the Radical SR8 Challenge at Oulton Park Circuit, excuse me. This is a 90-minute race with the Radical SR8 at the International with No Chicanes configuration of Oulton Park Circuit. This is my first road race since I started recording these races. I've had it made an attempt to record a couple in the past, but they messed up. I had some sort of issues that caused them not to work, and the road races that I haven't recorded have been fantastic, and I have regretted not recording them. So, finally got a road race in. This is going to be a very, very quick pace lap here. I'm car number 3 out of the 18 drivers starting in 10th. I have a contest going up on my page that has already been selected. I had people predict where I'm going to finish. That was for 5 iRacing credits. They will know, the winner will know that he won before this race gets uploaded to YouTube. So congratulations to whoever that was. Getting ready to go here, 90 minutes. I'm going to stop the video at some point just to let the camera rest so that way I can capture the finish. So I'll figure out when, but we're green, so let's go racing.
Clear on the right. Sorry guys, that was my fault.
Fairly slow start to this race. Another guy off track. I do not know if I mentioned this because I had to rush through what I was going to say, but this is my very first official race in the Radical SR8. I've driven this car before, but I have never raced it, so this is race number one. It was pretty fun from what I did in practice. I'm really comfortable with the car. I'm not extremely fast, but I'm comfortable and at a competitive speed. So we'll see how this goes tonight. Already moved my way up to 7th place. I have noticed from my laps in practice that this car is very, very hard to save once it slides. Trying to correct it the other way just overcorrects it and it just instantly snaps around on you. So that'll be interesting to try to deal with, to try to push the car to its peak, but not over the peak and down the mountain to where it'll cause some problems. Draft.
All clear, all clear.
If I had a little more room on that straightaway, I would have driven it a little harder to try to clear into the fifth. But I just did not want to do that, especially this early in the race. Try to be patient with this guy, so I can probably get by him on this backstretch. And then again, the guy behind me might be able to get by me too. spot. Into the top five. Behind me trying to get around. Guys, all over the back of me. Got a good run now.
All clear.
He backed out. Thank you. starting to make up ground on the guys in front of me too. So that's always good. Trying to get a little breathing room with the guy behind me now. I'm extending my gap on 6 and then I'm closing in on 4th, so that's always good, and kind of surprised at that actually. Now I'm not seeing that guy behind me at all. 6 seconds now. He must have made a mistake. I saw 4 cars in front of me and I got a little excited, but I guess the leader's out to lunch right now, and so one of those 4 cars must be a lapper. I'm only 3 seconds behind second place right now. And it is. Wow, we've got some pretty bad damage. Oh, and one spun. That was a car for position. We got a spot off of that. and the frame is starting to race a little bit, so I might be able to close in on him. Oh, I gained a ton of ground on them. Oh, and the one guy's off. Might be able to fly by him here. I will. Into third. Second place pushed way wide that turn. And we are in second right now, boys and girls and whoever else may be watching. This is incredible. So what I'm going to do, since the action has calmed down just a little bit, is this is where I'm going to take my break to turn the camera off, save the battery a little bit so it'll last the rest of the race. I'm about 9 to 10 laps away from making a pit stop, so what I will do is stop the camera for now, and once I make that pit stop, I will come back live for you guys for the rest of the race. So yeah, gonna stop it right here, and we'll continue on. Alrighty, on to the exit of the pit stop. What's going on, guys? It is Kyle back here, coming out of my first pit stop of the race. Just coming out of the pits now, as seen. Wasn't really a lot of intense action going on once I left you guys. I almost wrecked myself once, but I did save it. Sure what I was supposed to do on that pit stop as far as fueling and stuff. As mentioned before, this is my very first radical race, but I sat there the entire time that the car was fueling. It was like a 40 some odd second stop, and now that I'm looking at things, I feel like that was probably the wrong thing to do, especially with everybody talking about making two pit stops. Thank you. with me doing that, that has made the car a lot heavier. I mean, it has affected my driving. Just a little over a third of the way through this race. No. Crap. That is exactly what I meant by this thing gets difficult to say once you get it upset. Well, I made it as long as I did without any incidents, so that's not too bad. And it's only one. Thank you. little bit and slow up for it. Starting to close in on fourth, I noticed that the guy that I came out next to in the pits, he passed the guy, and now I've rapidly caught up on him, so it makes me wonder if he has messed up, hurt his car of some sort. I just drove off track. Crap, that sucks. So I'm curious as to why he has dropped back and why I have flown up onto him. He's heading into the pits now, so I will easily overtake his spot.
Thank you.
around, or just a little past halfway through this race, because we are 46 minutes in that last time by. Of this, I did it again. Oh my gosh, what the hell is wrong with me? Third place guy just messed up, and that's who I just passed, but I have quickly gained 4 off tracks after running this race instead of 3. I was looking great incident-wise, and within the last, 10 minutes probably, I've just racked up 5 incidents, all off tracks. And I dropped back down to 4th. I think I made the wrong call on the pit stop by taking all that fuel. Just made the car so much heavier, and it has totally changed the way this car drives. Thank you. What I find the sad part about all this is, even though the car is handled and has changed a drastic amount, I'm still running the same exact lap times that I was. I'm running the same lap times and I'm a lot tighter to these turns because the car has more weight. And I just can't get it to turn as well. If I had the ability to turn better like I did the first run, I would be way well away from that tank car and well ahead of him. I know that for a fact. See, like right there, it just like doesn't turn. This dude just totally gets in my freaking way. Thought that might be a better line to cut that earlier, but it just didn't end up working. I'm sliding all over the freaking place right now. Well, we'll use this to unlap ourselves. But I'm still nowhere near anybody to contend with right now. And as I say that, third place spins out. Now it's time for me to run away as fast as I can. So by looking at the time that the leader was behind me now, it really makes you feel like I made the wrong decision on pitting as far as how much fuel to take. Because he's only 18 some odd seconds behind me now. At least he was during that last lap. There's some more people behind me, so he got knocked off, but dumping all that fuel in the car was the wrong decision. Shifted one too many times right there, and just I'm losing focus now. This could have been a really, really good race for my safety rating. I'm really close to maxing out at 4.99, and after these incidents, I'll be lucky to gain safety rating. Gotta be freaking kidding me, come on! I'm making rookie mistakes, this is pathetic. Now, the leader's only 2 seconds behind me now, but the good news is something happened again to that 10 car, and he's absolutely nowhere to be seen in my mirror. Well, on my relative timing, so. Don't know why the leader just came in to pit. With it being as close as it was to his stop, I wonder if he had a penalty of some sort. I really don't know though.
Thank you.
the guy who led this whole race. Now I'm gonna have problems a freaking again. The guy who led this whole race just came in out of nowhere, unannounced, and loses a whole lap, loses the lead. That right there just told me that I had a shot to win this race.
We're on the right. We're on the right.
And just a stupid, stupid, stupid mistake. Caused me to make so many rookie mistakes. Cross him up and the car just gets loose. It doesn't make sense. It's loose on exit and it does not turn on entry. I don't. got to be kidding me, really? Such a rookie right now. This is so stupid. I had an incident-free race going an hour ago, and now I have 10 incidents. Two main factors why this race has just fallen apart for me. Number one is obviously the fact that I took way too much fuel unknowingly, or not knowing what I was supposed to do on that pit stop, and it just completely changed the handling of the car that has not gone back to the way it was at all. And number two is the fact that, once again, which apparently I can't seem to understand, is I am just extremely uncomfortable right now. I have a window open right next to me when it's gotta be at least 50 outside. But the fact that I have the audio coming out of my speakers and not through a headset where nobody can hear it means that I have to keep my door shut, and that just ignites my room in ridiculous heat, and I'm just uncomfortably hot right now. So, I mean, it's hard, it's probably a little ridiculous that I'm getting mad over this, because I'm still in third place. This is my first ever race in the Radical, and I'm in third place out of 18 people that started this race. Oh, and something else is I still have to figure out this head mount or figure something out on top of the GoPro, but this is, like it has always, is making my head throb where the GoPro is sitting, and it's annoyingly painful. I mean, it isn't like super painful, but it's enough to give me like a mild headache that's just annoying. And that's why in other videos I see the camera moving and stuff when I put my hand up to it, so I'm trying to pull away from my head. See, I gotta think, come up with something new to do to mount it or loosen this thing up. I thought I did, but I don't really know what I'm doing with this head mount. Something happened to Wayne to where I'm now back in second place. Thank you. Well, the second half of the race fell apart after a silly mistake in the pits, but I came back to where I ran the highest, and I just finished my very first Radical SR8 official race ever in second place. You know, I guess I can be a little upset at the fact that I ran incident free. I made a stupid mistake in the pits that affected the car's handling, and I made many, many mistakes that cost me 10 incident points. But at the end of the day, when push comes to shove, I really can't be too upset about what just transpired in this race. For the first time ever competing in a race in the Radical SRA, I just came home runner-up, second place, out of 18 people. I didn't think that was going to happen at all. I figured, you know, I was probably going to be a mid-pack driver, to where I was just riding around and, you know, I just didn't have the speed to contend with anybody. I mean, I got beat by a lot. A lot of that should be shorter because of the mistakes I made. But, you know, there really isn't a whole lot to complain about when you look at the finish. I feel like I might have been able to have a shot to win this race had I done the right strategy and had I not made the right mistakes, or made the mistakes that I made. But, you know, I at least now, you know, I can take what happened here today. I can move on from it. I can learn from it, I should say. Not move on, I meant to say learn. I can learn from it, learn how to, you know, make myself a little more comfortable driving, and, you know, try to maybe even make myself a better endurance racer, because it's tough for me to stay focused during endurance races. And, I cracked a little bit tonight. So the safety rating probably isn't going to be a number that I'm going to like to see, but, it really wasn't as bad of a race. I'm sure the I rating, the finish, the points is going to make up for it in the long run here, as pit lane's over there. So, as I pull into the pits here, this is going to do it here for the race. The Road Warrior Series Radical SR8 Challenge 90-minute race at Oulton Park Circuit, the International with No Chicanes course. And Radical SR8, it was a total of 63 laps for the 90-minute race, and I ended up in second. Congratulations, if I can get my mouse, check his name again. Congratulations to Sean Woodhouse on the victory, and I would also like to give a shout-out and congratulations to Brandon Wilkinson on winning the $5 iRacing credits for the competition that I had on my Facebook page. Speaking of that, if you would like to know how you can get in on the next contest that I have on my Facebook page, and if you would like to keep up on every race that I do on iRacing that you don't see on YouTube, go to facebook.com/youngmotorsportssimracing. You can check out a race review of every single race that I do, including this one, on that page on the iRacing service. Great way to keep in touch with my sim racing, and it's also a really good way to make sure that you can catch yourself involved in one of my contests that I do every now and again. The one I did for this race, predict my finishing position, you get $5 in credits. Brandon Wilkinson did that, he gets $5 in credits. So go there, like the page, get involved, interact, you know, and let me know what you think. Thanks again for watching, guys. I'm sorry for the breakdown throughout the race. Just a little frustrated with some things that happened. But, you know, you live and learn from them. And hopefully we can do that today and, you know, improve. Thinking about running the races tomorrow. So we'll figure out what's going to happen with that. So thanks again for watching, guys. And until next time, bye-bye.